Oh, you hear the train? You hear the train coming? Yes, the train is on its way to you. God has got a promise for you. You've been on this road a long time, and you're looking at it and saying, man, there's no train coming for me. My possibilities, what's going to happen with my possibilities? Oh, but the train is coming. See, you may not see it, but you hear it. And we got the track ready, so keep your track ready, because the train is coming.
This is a forecast. It seems the storm just won't pass. For you it seems so dark, that day will never ever come into your life. Sunny and take me high up so I can see the rainbow. I wanna see your rainbow. For the rain causes many, many complications. Lord, I'm looking for your decoration.
Today for the Lord. We know you're gonna do awesome, so go in there and knock them out. And yeah, you always here to give us the encouragement. We just want to give you a little word of encouragement and say, God got you, and he gonna let you knock it out the park today. So, and just speak what God put on your heart and just be yourself, because that's all God expects you to do. Be yourself, and you more than enough. So let the Lord use you. He done called you, he done anointed you, and you ready. Go knock him out. Yes, because you were born for this, Miss Kay, so go give him what you got. And like Elsa, you were born for such a time as this, and the people need you. So go out there and just speak, and let God anoint your lips, and it'll come on off. We love you, and we're so proud of you. Keep doing that work for the kingdom. Yes. Bye.
Baxter Watson from Victoria, Texas. My last name is White Song. You take the W off, you get the Y, you use the song, and the White Song, you say it like that. I've been ordained for 10 years, but my mom always said, your life speaks for you, so it's not much I can say about myself. If you know me, my life speaks for me through my spirit. A word upon this morning. It's coming out of John chapter 5. Now you can stand back up for the reading of this word. It's coming out of John chapter 5, 6 and 7. When Jesus saw him lying there and learned that he had been in this condition for a long time, he asked him, do you want to get well? He said, sir, the valley man replied, I have no one to help me into the pool when the water is stirred. While I am trying to get in, someone else goes down ahead of me. And that's all I'm reading. Let us pray. Father God, I come to you right now as humbly as I know how, God. Lord, you know, you chose me today to give to your people back your word. So, Lord, I ask you to decrease me and increase you. Give me more of you, Lord God. Let your words come out, Father God, how you want it to do. Let the Holy Spirit take over, Father God. Let them see not me up here, but you, Father God, your words. So, Lord, I ask that your word protect your people, deliver your people. Father God, we come for no other just to lift up your name, to give you worship and the praise in this house. So Lord, I thank you. I praise your holy name. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
This morning, I want to talk about excuses. We all have excuses, no matter what we do. If we're on our jobs, or if we're at home, or even in church, we all have excuses. And we rely on our excuses a lot. And it's funny how I travel a lot. My job travels. I go from place to place, nursing home. Sometimes I go to hospitals, but mostly I work at the nursing home. So driving from Victoria to like New Brunswick, sometimes I come a lot to San Antonio, I drive. But on my journey, I talk to God. That's my opportunity by myself with God. And I just told God, just this week, last week, I said, Lord, blah, blah, blah. I said, but you asked me, I'm going to say yes. I'm not going to say no. Sometimes you have to watch what you pray for. It's come quick. But it's no excuses, even if something just comes up suddenly. There's no excuses to say, I can't, when you know you can. They always say you have something to give, even if it's a word. I mean, when I'm at work, I normally used to take index card, put the Bible scriptures on the card, put them in my pocket. I don't have that kind of money to give. But in nursing, you know, they always ask, especially when they find out you're a minister, they always want to ask you questions, blah, blah, blah. Then they talk about, excuse me, blah, blah. And they always want to ask questions, and you don't always have the right answer. But I always have the scriptures in my pocket. I say, I have a word for you, so I give them a word. And it makes me feel good knowing that I can give something back. And it's not always have to be money. It's not always have to be something that they really want, but something that they really need. And that's the word of God. And I was looking at this, well, yesterday, I didn't have a word at all. I'm like, oh Lord, what I'm gonna do? And I didn't know. And in my mind, I wanted to say no, because I didn't want to search for nothing. I didn't want to look for nothing. And I didn't want to do anything. But I had to say yes. I had to. And not just for his people, but just for me. Because God is teaching me as well as I'm standing here telling you about his word. To stop having excuses for everything. Because everything really don't have to take energy to put into it. We're scared that we're going to get our knees hurt or our hands hurt. And it just takes sometimes just a voice to even put things out. In this scripture, talk about a man who was bound down for 38 years. And he couldn't get in the pool. And I was thinking, like, what was wrong with this man? Why he didn't get no help getting into the pool? And you look at it, the pool was for the disabled. Is disabled helping disabled? You know, and maybe they didn't help them because they all was disabled. Maybe they couldn't lift him up, or maybe they couldn't do anything for this man. And we have friends like that. We have disabled friends that they can't lift us up to do anything, or they can't give us anything because they disabled themselves. So sometimes we have to change the route, or change friends, or find somebody who really can help us. But this man didn't have nobody for 38 years. Then I thought about his attitude. Maybe he had a bad attitude that they didn't help him. Maybe he was all for himself, or maybe he wasn't saying kind words to nobody, or maybe it was just his spirit wasn't right that they didn't help him. Sometimes you can be down, and sometimes your spirit can get you whatever you want. My daddy always said, baby, you keep a good name, people will always help you. Who want to help a rotten person? Oh, she mean to me, or I don't want to, no, because she mean, no. You want to help somebody who's kind to you. Oh, but I remember the time when I was out, you helped me. Or I remember the time that you was there. You always want to check your attitude towards people before you even ask for help. I believe what goes around comes around. If you treat somebody wrong, they're going to treat you wrong, as reap as you sow. I always try to sow good seeds, not just for me. I have 4 children and 12 grandkids. I want them to be blessed as well as I'm blessed. God said, when I'm blessed, my children blessed, and my their children blessed. So I want the blessings to stay flowing in with them. So you have to watch out how you talk to people, how you treat people. It comes back on you. This man was bound down for 30. Can't you imagine? You could be bound down for 38 years, can't get out the bed. All you have to can do is roll around, can't get up, can't lift your head. That is so horrible, horrible. But we, as even as Christian people, have to watch how we say what we say to people, or how we do anything to people. Oh, y'all so quiet on that. Y'all look nice and good. Y'all act like I'm talking about you instead of telling you. Come on, man.
You're doing good.
That's all right. But I'm going somewhere with this. There's no more excuses when I finish this. Because Jesus came and made a way for this man. He made a way.
Yes, he did.
I was bound down for a whole year without a car. 30 miles from the place I was going to where I live. My church was in another town. I had to catch rides. And I was also praying to God, Lord, I need a car, Lord. I need. I was just praying to God. But I had to catch rides to work. I even had bake sales for the church. I was paying my tithes. I was preaching. I was teaching Sunday school. And I still didn't have what I wanted from God. Lord, what is it? What am I missing? I'm being faithful to you. Everything you need me to do, I'm doing. But I had to realize until I start calling those things out, Lord, thank you for that new car in my driveway. Thank you, Lord. I speak newness every day for a car. After a year passed,
Amen. My
best friend called me. She said, Kay, Blum, Kay, you can get up and go down there to this car dealership. I'll tell you one thing. I went. didn't have no money. See, your life speaks for you. Your spirit speaks for you. When you change your attitude, you can get anything you want, I promise you. If you just don't walk around so ugly and mean and cruel to people, God will bless you because that's what he sees. Because when you say you is in Christ, people are going to see the Christ in you. And sometimes they don't even have to even do anything. They can say, you a godly woman or you a godly man. But they see the Spirit of God upon you. I went to the car dealership with no money. And I needed to put some money down, but my son had to co-sign for me. He and I was in the same boat. So, just like the man at the thing, all these people around him, they all was disabled. But he said, okay, you give me $1,500. I didn't have $1,500, so I gave him a check. He said, hold the check for 2 weeks. This is when I just started being a CNA. I've been a CNA for 2 years. But this is when I just started working. So I gave him a check. He said he hold it for 3 weeks. Then after I gave him a check, he said he hold it for 3 weeks. He gave me the car keys. I didn't sign no papers. He said, go to your insurance people and get the insurance on your car. So here I'm driving these people's car with no paper signing. I mean, if I would have got stopped, they would ask for registration. I would have go to pen because I think I had stolen a car. And I was innocent. But the whole thing is, I got a car. I was the last one who brought a car off that lot. The lot shut down, it closed. So my car was waiting on me. But if I had not was to get up to go get that car, I probably still would have been carless. I was being obedient to what God was leading me to. So he gave my best friend a word for me to go and get this car. So and then as well, I was being trustworthy because when he did run the check through, everything was clear. Amen. It passed. And I said, God, it was nothing but you. Amen. Nothing but you. So I thank God for that. So what I'm saying is this man was bound down for 38 years. And he didn't have no one to put him in the pool. In this pool, an angel came down and she stirred up the water. She stirred it up. And when she stirred it up, they get in the pool to get their healing. And it was nothing but disabled people. That was the pool of the House of Mercy. They get in and they get healed. But he never got in the pool because Jesus made a way for him. Jesus came and he made a way. And we know that many of us, Jesus came and he made a way for us. Amen. He made a way for us when we was all torn up, all right. Broken. We need deliverance. We need healing. We needed our mind to be set free from some things.
Yes.
We need God to just touch us any kind of way, any kind of way, no matter how. It's like a pregnant woman when she go into labor. Lord, just touch this body, get this baby out. That's the pain. But Jesus came and he made a way. How many of y'all know that Jesus came to make a way for y'all today? To be set free from some of the things that y'all have been burned down for too long. 38 years is, I passed 38 years, but 38 years is a long time. You can do a lot in 38 years. But just imagine that he was bound down that long that he couldn't get up. We get mad if we can't get up in the morning when our knees hurt, crippling.
Right.
Get up with a headache.
Yeah.
This man ought to teach us that, hey, we can do anything because we got our health and strength.
Yeah.
I hear somebody talk about wealth. Your health is your wealth. Right. If you don't have no health, you ain't got no wealth. You can't do nothing without your health. Rich people think because I got all this money in the bank, but if something happened to you, all that money in the bank is going to be spent on your health. So don't ever think that you, if they rich, you rich too. If you walking and talking and breathing, you just as rich as them. Because you can get there as well. See, God is good. And I love him so much. He brought me through many. And he brought me through plenty. I have been bound down and he lifted me up. I have been bound down in sickness. I was free. I bound down in anxiety. He freed me. I've been bound down in family matters, he freed me.
Yes.
because he's just that kind of God.
Yes, yes.
And I know sometimes when I think God is not that close to me, I breathe. Lord, you just that close to me.
All right. Man.
Because I have his breath in my body. And his breath is who we are. He breathes through us. And we just got to know and learn that God is there. Because he said he never leaves us, he never forsakes us. He said he's always there for us, no matter what we do. We need God. We need Jesus.
Yes.
He don't leave us. And no matter what we do, he's still there for us.
Yes.
No matter we do whatever, God is there for us. He never leaves us. And he's still teaching us and showing us the way. And sometimes our situations can just bow down us and we forget about God.
Yes.
Or we can get mad at God because this happened to us. Lord, this happened to me. And I came across plenty of people who say, I'm mad at God. Why are you mad at God? What did God do to you? You put your own self in there. And I can tell them, you have your own mind and you've grown. And you can set your own mind or make your own decision of what you choose. And you have the right to choose. You can tell me till I'm blue in the face. But when it comes down to a decision to make, it's on me.
Amen.
That's right.
And then when it's on me, I'm the one that has to pay the consequences for it.
Yes, yes.
I can't get mad at God, but I can pray and ask God. Mm-hmm. You have to have a praying life, a praying spirit to even continue in this lifetime.
Yes.
It's hard without God. It really is hard. And I really can't see how some people just can wake up without God on their mind.
Good morning. Amen.
Good morning, God. Good morning,
God.
Jesus. Good morning, Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Thank you for new grace and new mercy upon this day. Thank you for my life, health, and strength upon this day. Thank you for my activity of my limbs, Lord. Thank you for waking me up with a rose mind.
Yes.
Lord, I thank you for all that you're doing for me. I thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
He make a way out of no way, always. Always. He always there for us. And sometimes we're just too blind to see the love of God. Sometimes we're too blind just to know what he's doing for us in our lives.
Yeah. Yeah.
And sometimes it's hard to be obedient when you feel like it's not right. What do God do that makes sense? He does a lot of things that don't make sense. God, what do you want me to do that for? I know, I'm not going to do that. That's not me. But and then it's not about you.
Amen.
It's about being obedient of what he wants you
yes.
to do.
Yes.
And there's a lot of things that we don't want to do. We don't want to help that person because they're on the street. And I always think about the people on the street who stand out with the signs. People would rather give a rich man money than give them poor people money. Well, he ain't going to do nothing but do it. But what would you think the rich man going to do with your money as well?
Well,
it's a tick tack. Who cares? But be obedient and do what God said do.
Because
you never know, they really could be hungry. They really could pay that last dollar for something, but now they're hungry.
All right.
We do it as well.
Yes.
I know we work for our money, but we still do it. So we can be a blessing to others, whether they're in the streets or in a home or in business, wherever. Sow what God tells you to sow and be obedient. There's no excuses for us not to do anything that God tells us to do or we want to do. And sometimes we just don't feel like doing it. I don't feel like putting no clothes on. I don't feel like combing my hair. I don't feel like putting no makeup. We can get so comfortable in where we at that we don't want to move. But you know, when God bring us out, or want us to put that makeup on, or want you to get up and put them clothes on, or want you to get up and put yourself together, because there's somebody out there hurting, waiting on you to comfort them, to bring them a soft word to them.
Amen.
We don't realize the things that we can be stopping people doing just because we don't want to. If I had not got up to put on clothes to come to church, I was missed my opportunity that God gave me today. If you had not got up to be a pastor, be a first lady, if we had no anniversary for y'all today, it's because we don't feel like it, but we have to, and we got to remember that we have to do it because we don't want to do it, but God has a blessing in a way.
That's all right.
And Jesus came and he made a way for us all. He made that way. And we I thank him for it.
Amen.
Our problems and our tribulations and every storm that goes around us, we get caught up in them. And sometimes we get caught up in our storms that we forget where we at or what we do. But I heard Pastor talk about being content and with no worries in Christ and just being safe in his arms.
Yes.
But when we think about his goodness and what he brought us from, we can shout hallelujah in the midst of a storm. We can be content walking, knowing that everything is around us, all attacking us, but we're walking all good and nice with a smile on our face, knowing God got me. God got me. He's not going to put me in a boat without a paddle. But the devil will put you in a boat without a paddle. He'll leave you out there and make you try to find your way back. But guess what? You're going to have to call on Jesus to get you back in.
Yeah.
He's wonderful.
Yes, he is.
Excellent. He never leave us nor forsake us. Bound down for 38 years. I can't get over that. I was bound down for a year. I'm about to just lose it. I ain't got. But if you think about the things that people goes on in the Bible, we can't stand it. Well, I know I can't. I'm going to say me. Because y'all looking at me like I bet I can. But 38 years bound down with the same thing?
Yes. Long time.
38 years is a long time.
Long time.
I've been in school. I went to college, had four children, got married in 38 years. I did a lot. And just to be bound down with nothing, probably looking at the dirt all day, or looking sideways, or looking at people going into the pool and didn't have no help. That's horrible. I don't want to keep looking at people getting their blessings and I'm not blessed.
Amen.
I want to be blessed.
Hallelujah.
I'm gonna go in when you go in. Don't leave me out. You eating apple pie and I'm eating dirt. No, I'm gonna eat apple pie with you. Don't leave me out.
Alright.
You have to have that spirit of the Lord.
Yeah.
And the spirit of somebody wanna just help you. Like I was saying, an ugly spirit, who wanna be around it? Have you ever been around somebody with an ugly spirit and they catch you and you start talking like them? That's horrible. The girl that worked did that. She was talking like, oh no ma'am, I'll rebuke that spirit right now in Jesus' name. I'm not gonna have this. I talk with love. And she started laughing and said, no ma'am, spirits are catching and they will get on you.
Come on.
So you really have to watch who you're around and how you're around the spirit.
Preacher, this way.
So maybe because all of them was the same, disabled. Or maybe because he had a bad spirit. Or maybe it's just because we had to see that Jesus made a way.
Yes, yes.
Jesus made a way for him to pick up his bed and walk.
All right.
Amen.
Jesus made a way.
He had to pick up his bedroll and walk.
Yes.
Isn't it so nice that God, Jesus can say, just go through it. I got you. Just go pick a house out. It's yours. Or just gonna pick out anything you need, it's yours. But you got to have that spirit of believing and trusting God for everything you do.
All right.
For everything you want, he got it.
Yes.
He didn't leave nothing out for us.
Yes.
Nothing. We had it all. Even in our mama's wombs, we already had it. When we was pregnant with our children, mama was pregnant with us, the suitcase was packed. Nothing else could fit in but what God put in it.
All right.
And if anything else was in it, and because when you was born and came out and did your own thing, you packed your own suitcase and you put the devil in it. Should have kept it closed like mama told you.
All right.
That was a free one. God is good. No more excuses. You can do all things through Christ who strengthens you.
Yeah.
And I admire President because he did that. And people look like, oh no, I don't look at Trump like that. I look at that he's a man that went into president and didn't even know what he was doing. He went in, and we can do that. You can do anything you want to be, or be what you want to be. Just do it. You can be learned, you go on a new job, what they're going to do, they're going to teach you. They're going to teach you paperwork, they're going to teach you everything you need to know. But we don't want to get in no position because we think we're not fit for it, or we're not capable for it. You capable of anything you want to do. You can be the president if you want to. But Trump did it, you can do it. He made it. And then he made it for 4 years. Impeach him. No, they wasn't going to impeach him because that wasn't God's will for us. And we have to watch what we say about those things because, you don't know what's coming next. So you better enjoy Trump while he's in there because who can know what's coming next? You can get a president want to bum up the whole United States. Who knows? Just enjoy the moment that we have.
Amen. Preach
it. I'd be glad when this is over. No, enjoy it while you're in it. Because when it's finished, you don't know what's coming next.
That's right.
You never know. And people say, well, I wonder what's next. Don't worry about what's next. You might not can handle it because you barely handled what he was in.
Come on.
God is good.
Yes, yes.
He came and he made a way for this man who was bound down for 38 years. He came and he set me free from asking people for car rides and all this for over a year. And comparing them to a year and 38, thank you God, I had to go 38 years without a car. That would have been horrible. I probably would have had to forget how to drive. He is good.
Yes,
he is
good.
Awesome.
Yes, yes.
And he is worthy.
Yes.
And sometimes we feel like we have our problems and we let them problems bound us down and we just find ourselves wobbling in them.
Yes.
We find ourselves can't even control it no more because we let our minds go there instead of giving it to Jesus. Because God said, cast all our cares upon him because he cares. And that's what we have to do. We have to learn to give it to God.
Yes.
And no matter what. My thing is this. I tell God, Lord, you see the situation. I can't handle it. I can't do nothing. But I know you can do it. I know you can fix it. And I get out the way. And I go on through my day. I might not like everybody who comes in my face. I love everybody. But I might not like things that goes around me. But I'm going to be well content in God.
Amen.
Because I know he got my back. And I know that he can fix it. What can I do? I can't fight. I'm 53 years old. I'm not about to fight. That's crazy. Only dogs fight because they can't talk things out.
Come on.
And I'm not no animal. What can I do with a fight? Brother Larry, you might can fight that karate stuff. I can't do that. I just look at it. But I can't, and I wouldn't touch it. I let God fight my battles.
Right.
I don't care what it is. It can be a argument over milk. I would tell God about it. Because that's all I know, is to pray about situations of whatever goes on in my life. And I know he will fix it.
Yes, yes.
He fixed it back then.
Yes.
And I know he'll fix it now.
Yes.
Because he's just that kind of God.
Yes.
He came and he made a way for us. He made us a way so we don't have to go through all this chaos. He made a way that we don't have to go through our disables and our disappointments and the situations that we get in. Jesus came and he set all that free for us, but we still find ourselves in a storm.
Amen.
There's hailing and lightning and floods and everything around us. So we put ourselves in a situation. Sometimes we can get too nosy and want to find things out and finding ourselves building situations on our own self. And you know the kind of people that you in the crowd, but you the one get picked out? Yeah. If you one of them people, stay away from situations.
Amen.
He's a merciful God.
Amen.
He had a merciful house of mercy for the disabled to be healed.
Yes, he is.
When the angels stirred up the poor, they was healed. But when Jesus came and died for us, we was healed.
Yeah.
And I thank God for the cross.
Yeah.
I thank God he died on the cross for us. And a lot of people don't understand what that cross means, but it means so much to me.
All right.
Yes, ma'am.
Because without that, God had died for not just me, but for all of us.
Yes.
We wouldn't be set free from a lot of things that we've been through.
Yes.
So we shouldn't never have excuses to do anything for anybody.
All right.
Because what we go through is not ourselves.
Yes.
Any kind of test we go through is not for us.
Amen.
It's for that person who's hurting, who can't go through it. We don't have the right to keep that.
All right.
I got to heal somebody. I got to tell somebody that I know a man.
Yeah.
And I can't do it from home. I can't do it for laying in the bed watching soap operas. I can't do it for just going fishing. Well, I might be fishing because it might be a fisherman out there who needs Jesus. But you can't do it closed up.
Yes,
ma'am.
You have to go out
and be a witness
for Jesus.
Yes, good.
And let somebody know.
Let somebody know.
That you've been there.
All right.
You've done that. And now I'm going to help you do it.
Yes.
And if they don't do it, if they don't listen to you, it's not on you. That's on them.
Yes.
You ain't did nothing but be obedient to what God called you to do.
Yes. All right.
Amen.
So take this with you today. No more excuses.
No more.
When you don't feel like doing it, that means somebody out there needs you. Get up and put them clothes on. Put that makeup on, whatever it takes. But go out there because somebody's waiting on you. To be delivered. They want to pick up their bedroll and go.
All right.
I thank God for this message for me today. Because it helped me a lot.
Amen.
Because a lot of times I can be lazy. I don't want to do it at times. But I know now I have to do it. Because it's not about me.
Yeah.
It's about those out there who needs me. Let us pray. Father God, we thank you for this word upon today.
Yes,
we thank you that we have no more excuses.
Thank
and Lord,
you
have and you made a way for us all, God.
Yes.
Lord, now we let us go so
thank
we can deliver someone out of this situation that they're in. Lord, we thank you for all that you're doing upon this day, God.
Yes.
Bless this church, Father God. Continue to let your glory flow in this church, Father God. Bless the man of God over this church. Bless the woman of God over this church, God. Continue to lift them up, Father God. Strengthen them every day, Lord God. Father, we know that you are a way maker, God. That you do all that you do for us, God. And Lord, we thank you for loving us, Father God. But never forget that we're here, Father God. We can feel your breath, God.
Yes,
we feel
yes.
your love, God. We feel your presence upon this day, God. So, Lord, we thank you for all that you're doing,
thank
Jesus.
You.
And bless this appreciation upon this evening, Father God. Let it be what you have it to be. Let the Holy Spirit move, Father God. Remove self out, Father God. And let us all just rejoice in this day, God. We love you. We praise you in Jesus' name. Amen.
John 5 and 6 said, I have no man. Right. Y'all help me with this before we hit this song. Let's see, excuses. Jacob was a cheater. Somebody help me say that.
David
had an affair.
Noah got drunk.
Paul was a murderer.
Peter was a liar.
Judas was a backstabber. Jonah ran from God.
Gideon was insecure.
Solomon was a womanizer. Marion was a gossiper. Zacchaeus was short.
Abraham was old.
Lazarus was dead. Now look at yourself and say, what's my excuse?
Because of who you are.
Because of who you are, I give you praise. Ooh. Because of who you are, I will lift my voice and sing. Lord, we worship you because of who you are.
Stand with us as we pray.
Lord, we worship you because of who you are.